Good evening, everyone. I'm Ajit Puthenputhussery. I'm from New Jersey Institute of Technology. I'm here to present my paper, Generative and Discriminative Sparse Coding for Image Classification Applications. This is a joint work with my colleagues, Qingfeng Liu, Hao Liu, and my advisor, Chengjun Liu. So first, let me start by explaining a general sparse coding problem. So in a sparse coding problem, the test case, the test sample, is a linear combination of the training samples. So we can see the diagram here. The test sample X is the linear combination of the training samples. So all the samples of the same class, they have a large coefficients, whereas samples of different classes will have zero or very low coefficients. And in order to derive these coefficients, we will use the following objective function. Okay, so now a potential limitation with this approach is that it does not consider the discriminative information or the generative information. The generative criterion helps to model the data distribution, and it may help to infer joint representation, which can increase the classification performance. Also, the discriminative information is essential since it helps to improve the distance between the samples of different classes. So our proposed method, GDSR, it has basically three novelties. The first one is that we apply a generative criterion wherein we use the dictionary distribution coefficients. The dictionary distribution coefficients are estimated by representing every dictionary item as a linear combination of the training samples. The next criterion we use is a discriminative criterion, which we apply using new localized within class and between class Kato matrices. We also propose a GDSR-based classification method that utilizes both the derived sparse representation and the distribution coefficients. So we have a diagram of the framework. So here we have the input feature vector, and we have three criterion in our objective function. The first one is the traditional sparse representation criterion. Then we have a generative criterion, wherein we represent every dictionary item as a linear combination of the training sample. And finally, we have our discriminative criterion, where we use new localized within class and between class Kato matrices for discriminant analysis. And that's the formula for our classifier. Okay, so these are the data sets used for evaluation. We used 15 scene categories, MIT 67 and Caltech 256 data set. And these are some experimental results we have. So we compared with state-of-the-art sparse coding as well as deep learning methods. Okay, so finally, I would like to show the TSNE visualization. So TSNE, T-stochastic neighborhood embedding visualization, is a technique used to visualize high-dimensional data. So in this, the image on the left-hand side are the input features, and the image on the right-hand side are the features after applying the GDSR method. So from the figure, we can see that the images on the right-hand side are have more distance between the samples of different classes. Our method also reduces the distance between samples of the same class. So this results in better discrimination among different classes, thereby improving the classification performance. So if you have any questions, please visit our poster. It's 3C11, and thank you very much.